Oh, hello there. So you want to know about the functions of plants and animal organs, huh? In plants, each organ has several jobs or functions. For example, root keeps a plant in the ground. They also take water and nutrients from the soil. Leaves absorb sunlight and make food for the plant by photosynthesis. The waste product of photosynthesis, oxygen, escapes through tiny holes in the leaves. The stem supports the leaves and flowers. It also transports waters and nutrients between the roots and leaves. Every plant organ is adapted to its function. For example, leaves that are big and flat absorb plenty of sunlight for photosynthesis. Long roots keep a tree stable and take water from deep in the soil. But some plants are unusual adaptations. For example, a potato has a swollen underground stem. It fills up with starch in the summer and stays alive in the soil in winter. In spring, the potato uses the stored starch to grow and make new leaves. And that's it for plant organ and their functions. Here's Mr. Taborada to tell you about the functions of animal organs.
Thank you for that wonderful explanation, Mr. Rodriguez. Because even the simplest animals are exceedingly complicated. Advanced vertebrates like birds and mammals are composed of so many deeply intermeshed, mutually dependent moving parts that it can be hard for a non-biologist to keep track on. There are 12 organ systems shared by most higher animals, like circulatory system, which is the function is to supply oxygen, which are networks of arteries, veins, and capillaries that carry oxygen containing blood cell in each organ. We also have respiratory system, which is a function is to help their body absorb oxygen from the air so their organs can work. And animals also have nervous system, which enables them to send, receive, and process the nerve and sensory impulses, as well as to move their muscles. On the other hand, the digestive system, this system moves the food throughout the animal's body and absorbs the product of digestion. Animals also have this system, which we call endocrine system, that encompasses a group of tissues that release hormones into circulation. Animals also have the most important system, which is the reproductive system, which is the biological system made up of all anatomical organs, which also allow animals to reproduce their species. They also have muscular system, which consists of muscle tissues that allow them to both move and control their movements. On the other hand, like us humans, animals also have immune system, which is a complex network of organs containing cells that recognize foreign substances in the body and destroy them. It protects vertebrates against pathogens or infectious agents such as viruses, bacteria, fungi, and other parasites. Animals also have skeletal system, which provides structure and protection for a variety of organisms, as well as urinary system, which is a function is to filter blood and create urine as a waste byproduct. The organs of the urinary system include the kidney, renal pelvis, ureters, bladder, and urethra. And the animals also have protective covering, which is the integumentary system, which distinguishes, separates, protects, and informs the animals with regard to its surroundings. For example, feathers of bird, scales of fish, hair of mammals, as well as claws, nails, hooves, and the like.